Hello, I'm Harshita Rana from the Biodiversity and Paleobiology Department of Agarkar Research Institute, Pune. I'm working as a research student on the project Modernization of Fossil Repository under the guidance of Dr. Tushar Kaushik and Dr. Kantimati Kulkarni. So, to begin with, what exactly are fossils? Fossils are remains of ancient organisms, both plants and animals, preserved in rocks. When paleontologists carry out research, they work with a number of fossil specimens. Specimens showing the best preservation of the diagnostic characters of a genus or species are preserved separately by the researchers. This collection is known as a repository, and the specimens kept here are known as type specimens. The fossil repository at ARI houses over 7,000 specimens, including major fossil groups like mollusks, echinoids, plant fossils, trace fossils, and microfossils. The fossils come from various parts of India, including Rajasthan, Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Karnataka, and Tamil Nadu. It is the third largest repository of its kind in the country, and in fact it is known for its largest and oldest ichnofossil collection in India. The ARI repository consists of a mobile compactor with multiple drawers of various sizes. Each rack and every individual compartment is labeled systematically, which becomes the address of each specimen. The fossils deposited here bear a unique registration number identified with an acronym MACSG, that is Maharashtra Association for Cultivation of Science Geology. Simultaneously, the details of a specimen as regards its name, classification, authority, geographic location, geological age, etc. are entered in a register, an Excel sheet, and also on a card that is kept along each specimen. Now, under this project, all the specimens are being photographed and all the data related to each specimen, including its repository number and repository address, is being maintained in an Excel sheet. So, given the name, a specimen can be tracked in a minute, along with its picture. All of this will be uploaded online so that it is even more easily available to everyone. Precautionary measures are strictly undertaken to minimize the risk of damage to the fossil specimens. Wherever required, adhesives are used to bind loose sediments or to repair the damaged ones. So now, why do we really need a repository? We all know fossils help us to learn the history of life on Earth and thus should be conserved. A repository in a sense helps us to do so. But since all the specimens in a repository are type specimens, it does so much more. It provides reference material that is essential for various studies in paleontology like taxonomy, paleoecology, climate change patterns, etc. For researchers, it provides data that helps them in planning new research projects, identifying new areas, field trips, etc., and acts as a support to their work. The ARI repository is consulted by scientists as well as research students from India and abroad for comparative studies. And through this project, all of this important information is being made more easily available for researchers all around the world. Thank you.